Hi, and welcome to the Home Assistant How-To with BeardedTinker. Today, we are going to install Yr.no weather sensor, a sensor for Norwegian Meteorological Institute. Stick around, and in 10 seconds, we will start. Okay, let's go into the Synology. We have to log in. We will now open our configuration folder, file station, home assistant, and we will open sensor.yaml file. Here at the bottom, we will add configuration for the YR weather service from the Norwegian Meteorological Institute. It's pretty simple. We add following platform YR. So we have defined the platform. System now knows what component to load. Next, we will give it a name. If you will be using more than one component, of course, then you can select another name, for example, yrweather or yr.no. But for now, we will leave it as is. Next step is to define for what period we want forecast presented. I'm interested in 24 hours, so it's forecast 24. After that, although component is at this point configured already, it's good practice to define what conditions you want to monitor or you don't want to monitor. This is also done again with the monitor conditions. And here we will just list all the conditions we want to monitor and see in our home assistant. I will just paste here all the variables I have prepared. We will monitor temperature, a symbol, pressure, fog, and all other listed components here. Okay, let's press save. And we can now go back into the home assistant. In home assistant, we will go to the configuration. We'll press server control, check config to see if everything is correct in configuration. If everything is okay, we'll press restart. And our system is up and running once again. Let us go back to overview. Here I will create a new tab. We currently have Home and Synology. I will create the Weather tab, so later on we can add some additional weather components. We will name it Weather and save it. Let's go there. Here we can add conditions we are now monitoring. But since I will not go into details of putting fancy gouges or graphs or everything, I will just do an entities list as I always do here. Okay, let's see if everything is loaded. Yes, we have already. Okay, so let's search for the weather temperature. Let's type weather humidity. Cloudiness. Let's do a symbol. It's 4. We can change it later on. Pressure. No rain. Dew point. Fog, high clouds, wind speed, wind direction, And those are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And I think we had 13 overall. Okay, but let's say this is just it for now. Or we can add, oh, sorry, fog, dewpoint, precipitation, pressure, symbol, cloudiness, humidity, temperature. Low clouds. I think more or less this should be it. Let's save it. And we now have here all the necessary data in the Home Assistant. Yr.no component is now configured. And you can, of course, play with it or add some automations. For example, if temperature outside is dropping or it's rising, to give you notification or to give you some kind of indication of what will be weather like in next 24 hours or so. Thank you very much for watching Home Assistant How-To with BeardedTinker. I hope you like this short video. If you would want to see some specific component, please drop me a comment down below. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe and hit the bell button so you get notified. Of course, if you like this video, press a like. Thank you, and until the next time. Bye-bye.